Hi, good morning children. I am Neetu and I am a teacher at First Cry in Jerry Tots, Manikonda, Hyderabad. Today we are doing the story session of our summer camp. Okay, you like stories? Yes, children? Okay, today we are going to tell a story about a lion and a fox. So the lion and the fox are the main characters of this story. Okay? And this happens in a forest. There are so many animals living in the forest. You can see so many animals. There are so many animals living in the forest, and it happens in a big forest. And the title of the story is Sick Lion and a Clever Fox. Sick Lion and a Clever Fox. So let's start, children. Once upon a time, there was a big forest and there was a lion and a fox living in the forest. So the lion was very sick and old, and he cannot run and catch his prey, and he started starving. So he thought of some plans, how to get some animals to eat. I am starving now. So he thought of some wicked plans so that he can rest inside his den and he can catch the animals. So he made some plans and he talked to each and every animal. See, I am so sick now. You all please come to visit me in my den. So, and he went inside the den and he sat in front of his cave. So few animals, all the animals started visiting the lion initially, and they asked about the health of the lion. So the lion said, thank you for asking about my health. And these animals went back. And after few days, when the animals went to inquire about the lion's health, what the lion did, children, you know? The lion will tell the animals that, please get inside. I'm so sick. I cannot even lift my hand. So can you please help me? My medicine is inside my cave. And can you please get those medicines? So one day when the zebra came, he said, okay, I will help you. And he went inside. And he went inside the cave. As he went inside, what the lion did? He ran and just killed the zebra and ate the zebra. So, and he sat in front of the den again, waiting for his next prey. So next day, rabbit came to inquire about the lion's health. So lion said, oh, thank you, rabbit. Can you help me to get my medicine inside? I cannot lift my hands. Can you help me? I'm so weak now. So rabbit said, okay, lion, I will help you. And he went inside the cave. As he went inside the cave, what the lion did? He ran and catch him and eat him. So again, he started sitting in front of the cave, waiting for the next prey. And the fox was very clever, understood that something is happening in the lion's den. He thought that the animals which are paying visit to the lion's den are not coming back. They are just disappearing from the forest. So he thought, I have to find out what is happening in the lion's den. So one day, next day, he went to the lion's den and asked him, how are you, lion? How are you fine? No, fox, I'm so weak. I cannot even lift my hand. So can you please help me to get the medicines which I have kept inside the cave? So the fox understood, oh, this is the plan of the lion to make the animals get inside. So he looked around and he find that the footprints are just footprints of the other animals are just going inside. They are not coming outside. So he asked lion, why these footprints are just going inside? Are all my friends inside your cave? No, anyway, that is not possible. So where are my other animals? So the lion said, he tried to explain himself. He said, I just erased all those footprints. That way it is not visible for you. So the clever fox said, no, that is not a satisfactory answer, that you are lying. So the lion said, no, I'm not lying. But the fox said, no, you don't try to explain yourself. I understood what is your plan and you are eating all the animals in the forest. So he said, now I will go back to the forest and I will tell all my friends to not pay visit to your den. And no other animals will, today onwards, no any animals will come to your den. And he ran away. And he told all the animals, if you love your life, don't pay visit to the lion's den anymore. He is catching all the animals and eating all the animals. So now onwards, don't go to the lion's den. And after that day, none of the animals went to the lion's den. And what happened to the lion? He starved to death. So what is the moral of the story, children? You should not tell a lie for your selfish needs. If you tell a lie for your selfish needs, you will be left alone and your life will end up in a misery. So children, hope you like the story and you all have to take care of yourself. Stay safe at home. Wash your hands with soap and water and take care. Bye-bye.